right, that's just a booger on the windshield. Oh my god.
Like during our show, competing on the national NHRA jet circuit, Bill also participates year-round around the country at special events such as air shows. A love affair of his as an Air Force vet and now full-time air show performer. We continue to watch as he brings the heat. Those afterburner flames coming out the back, nearly 60 feet long. One, and we are on the roll. There's 200, 250, 352 miles an hour. How about that, ladies and gentlemen? Let's put our gentlemen, if you will, let's give a big bullhead often welcome to Brad Wurston, the incredible American-built MX-2. Inverted position and watch him as he rolls the aircraft around consistently, making Brad Wurston one of the finest air show performers in North America today. That air show smoke exploding in the sky as he hurls this airplane around. A Brad Wurston. This MX-2, an amazing machine, made mostly of carbon fiber and other lightweight composites, that weighs in at just 1,200 pounds as he goes into this maneuver known as the... attended Utah State University, where he enrolled in their aeronautics program, and by the age of 19 years old, he had his pilot's license. By the age of 25, he wanted to become an air show pilot, so he did. And trained and mentored by world-renowned aerobatic pilot Wayne Handley, Brad went on to fly a variety of air show aircraft on the circuit, now flying this highly impressive... Did you just do a forward flip?
Yeah, buddy.
You might call that the flip top. I'm going to call that hashtag no for me.
Come on. You got them trainer wink on that bad boy.
Son of a backup wink.
Laughlin Ranch for the official Laughlin Bullhead Airshow After Party. Festivities begin at 4 p.m. with drink and food specials plus extra special adult Easter egg hunt with over 5,000 eggs. It's at the Laughlin Ranch tonight starting at 4 p.m. But right now, as John Melby taxis his way back to his... says the P-63 is a thoroughbred and says you never quite own a King Cobra or any warbird in that manner. You're just lucky enough to serve as the steward of this great piece of history and to serve as the avenue to transition it from... But right now, as the P-63 pitches out and sets up to land, we are now going to transition to the European Theater of Opera. Ladies and gentlemen, we have received a dispatch from Washington as the situation in the Pacific is not improving, and nor are the diplomatic discussions. They ask you, the Zero, armed with two 7.7mm machine guns and two 20mm cannons, its heavy firepower allowed it to be a formal enemy at the beginning of World War II. Over time, and as the war in the Pacific escalated, American production kicked into high gear. Producing some 2,000 horsepower, it was armed with six 50 caliber machine guns, each with 400 rounds of ammunition, 2,400 bullets. The Hellcat, weighing in over 12,000 pounds, fully loaded, could fly in speeds of Victory Pass. Side by side, the Mitsubishi Zero and the Grumman Hellcat. We are very glad that you are here. Aerobatic flying takes a great deal of skill. She extends to the right end of our airshow box, pulls back on the stick, and does a maneuver now that uses her ailerons, her elevator, and her rudder to stop her biplane exactly where she wants it. This is Vicki Vincent, full hesitation roll. Performed with precision. In addition to aerobatics, Vicki got the air racing bug after being invited to participate in the coveted Pylon Racing School in Reno, and later went on to compete at the National Championship Air Races. She won her first race ever and was dubbed Rookie of the Year and competes in various race classes in the event, including the coveted Jet Class. Inbound now from our left side, climbing that super steerman at over 150 miles an hour. And that Pratt & Whitney engine at power as she combined that is nothing less than an art form in the sky. This particular steerman was manufactured in 1940 by the Boeing Company in Tulsa, Oklahoma. It served during World War II, where hundreds of American pilots learned to fly in it. After the war ended, it was sold surplus to a private owner in California for just $770. It went on to serve as a crop. Smoke is on now, ramping up to Smoke and Thunder's maximum power of 100% RPM. 3, 2, 1, and we are now off. We've got a race. Bill Brock accelerating well over 200, 250, 300 miles an hour. There's 360, 375 miles an hour. Ladies and gentlemen, how are your olds, if the case may be? And appreciation to having the A-10 demo team in the Heritage Flight here with us as part of the 2023 Laughlin Bullhead Air Show. We are just a couple seconds away, ladies and gentlemen, from turning the airspace over to the U.S. Air Force, and we are going to be in for a great demonstration showcasing the full tactical capabilities in flight of the A-10 Thunderbolt 2.
Run them up. All right. Everybody shaking, 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 everybody sha
Captain Johnson pulls back on the stick, slingshotting the A-10 straight into the vertical, showcasing the Hawk's power and maneuverability in all attitude perfect. From the right, the slow roll. Presents the dedication pass. Just as free. Once again, we salute all those fighting in today's. World War II era P-51 Mustang, piloted by Steve Hinton, and a United States Air Force A-10 Thunderbolt II, piloted by Captain Lindsey Mad Johnson.